Hi, Solomon. My name's Matthew from HDM Solar. I'm here with Solomon from Mounting Systems to have a look at the FD3 system.
FD3 systems. Yeah, FD3 is basically, I'm sure you know, the most innovative product that we have regarding flat roof systems.
Yeah.
It's quite easy.
It certainly looks straightforward.
It really looks quite easy because it's easy on two fronts. One, you don't need any kind of extra heavy equipment to install it. You could just click in, click out as you go from system to system, from array to array. And the second thing is, it's quite easy to stock and to transport, because this innovative middle support, as you know, kind of doubles as a 10 degree and a 15 degree support, depending on what kind of system you want. Plus, it could be used for east-west systems and also for south systems. So it's
okay, so it's one part fits four different
things.
Options.
So it's a four-in-one article. How this would work is...
And it's all this aluminium, so it's lightweight and...
It is aluminium. It's quite actually regular when we come to the rails. It's like a 6063 series aluminium. And this one is a special alloy called Zamac. We use it to...
And this is your own invention, almost?
Well, the Zamac is not. Our invention has been invented before, but the design incorporates the use of the Zamac, the advantage of the Zamac, to make sure that we can use it on a wider array of areas.
Okay.
Next to the sea, next to the chemical factories
So, and everybody. So the benefits to using the Zamac is it's highly corrosive corrosion resistant.
Exactly. And then it's durability,
waterproof,
of course.
Exactly. Strong.
Strong, and then also great for statics as well. So yeah, we kind of took advantage of that use, and then we designed this very nice, sturdy looking middle support.
Yeah.
So we're going to be building now like the 15 degree east-west system.
Okay.
In the east-west system, we only have the 15 degrees, and in the south system, we have the choice to go from 15 to 10.
To 10.
So starting off with the middle support, like I said, we could just use these pins to just change the angles from 10 to 15. You just have to align it with all the holes. It goes like that. The other one goes like this.
Much easier.
Sorry, 15 degrees. So this is...
But that shows how easy it is to change if
absolutely.
You do get it wrong.
And if you get confused also, you have to be careful because it's so easy to miss. Then we put this in the middle, of course, and then we have like those
little
places.
So these lengths are preset for... is a 15 degree east-west piece of rail.
This rail is only for the 15 degrees. It comes pre-assembled with the middle feet here.
Yeah.
So what we have to do is just, like I said, move this into place until you hear it click twice.
There's one.
And the second
the other.
One. Yep.
So that's locked that in now. That's
locked.
That's
so you don't
going
have
nowhere.
To do, yeah, no tools required, like I said before. Then we can go ahead and assemble the front feet here.
I'll copy and follow you with this.
Yeah, absolutely. So we got the EPDM rubber here.
Yeah.
This rubber has like a wide variety of uses. For example, if it is like a very sunny day in southern and Tuscany, and then it's like 40 degrees and your bitumen roof is melting off, you don't want this to sink into your roof.
I mean, bitumen might not be the best choice
absolutely.
In Tuscany, but there we go.
Absolutely. So you don't want this to melt into the bitumen roof what you have. So this is kind of a protection mat, yeah. Works with every kind of roof, basically. So it's designed to be clicking in very easily. So what I do is just push this into the other end, push this down, and then, as you can see, I can just,
we
did that
really
already.
Simple.
Wow, okay. So we have that already. And we put these on either ends of the rail.
Do I put this on?
Yes, very nice. So this is the front support, the other end of the...
So this holds the bottom of the...
The other end of the panel.
The other end of the panel.
The end. Yes, so we have a little groove here again. We put it in the groove, and then we make sure...
So I'll turn mine around?
Yep, like this. So you see the mounting system's facing the back one, yeah.
Yeah.
Like here.
So that would hold the bottom of the panel.
Yeah, exactly. So this... Puts it in, and then what we do, we slide
so
this
like
in
the,
like we
so
said.
Much like the center one, it just slides over
until you hear it click,
locked in place.
Let's see how you did over there.
It's not quite.
Wait, let's see. Yeah. Yes, there you go. So everything is now locked in place. And imagine if you were like a very good installer, you could have done this in a minute. I'm the one that's dragging you guys down.
You need a bit more practice, that's all it is.
Absolutely. And same goes for the middle support.
I've just noticed with the rubber, the EDPM feet, the holes through the middle.
Yeah, this is for if water flows this direction and it just goes one end and comes out the other.
Oh, right, so it helps keep things dry.
Absolutely. And also for ventilation if it's...
Could you use it for cable management as well?
We use the rails for cable management.
Use the rail for the cable management.
If you have this channel, you can use it for a certain amount of rails, of course. Same thing, rubber's into the middle. So we're kind of done with the rail.
So all these could be pre-assembled. If you had a job with 100 of these, you could actually pre-assemble these in a factory, dry, ready to go up on a wet, miserable wet autumn day.
Absolutely, that's the whole intent. So you don't have to actually waste a lot of time and energy just doing this. And also try to take it in and out of heavy equipment up the roof.
Yeah, because I mean, this is still very light, even
it is.
All assembled.
It is quite nice to work with. So we're done with this. So
and that's
what
it.
We do, the rail assessment, we do the same thing on the other side.
Yeah.
Then we have our ruler here.
So this is preset to the length of the panel.
Exactly. So depending on the side of the panel that we use, we kind of have those stops here. Where we can unpin and pin so we can adjust how much apart we want the rails to be according to the side of the panels. And then we put that here on either end of the rail
just
so we know exactly how far apart to get this. Then we do this on the other side without moving this.
That's the trick.
Yeah, exactly. Sorry.
Or hitting the chair.
Absolutely. Hitting the chair is critical. This should work.
So that's it. So that's ready for two panels.
Yeah, exactly. We can actually include an order of these if you email this about email is about the need about this. Okay. Then we have the wind deflectors, but before we put the wind deflectors on, let's go ahead and put the counterballast on, and then we can put the wind the PV on, and
so
then
this is the ballast tray. So this is
this is the ballast tray.
This is what would hold the weight to actually support it on the roof.
Exactly.
For when inevitably it does get windy.
Basically, this is the attachment system for the entire system. Let's say we need a counterweight mechanism to put weight on these rails so they don't fly away, basically. So
because they're that light.
We do not want that, no. We do not want this. So we put this on either end.
This doesn't feel like aluminium though, this one.
This is not aluminium. This is a stainless steel tray. Yeah, you're all right.
Yeah.
I think you're good.
So it does, it just sits,
right
just rests
there.
On top of the...
Yeah. How we will finish it, we will bend this inwards into the rail.
Yeah.
You see this like a tear here?
Oh yeah.
We'll just bend this when we want it just to stay. But now we have to remove it later on. So we're now going to bend this.
So depending how long your panels are, you then just lay another one of these, a ballast tray on top.
Absolutely.
Another one of these, a ballast tray on top.
So you could get
keep
the
going
system
along.
Going.
And is there a limit to how many you should put in a line?
Well, we will tell you that when we calculate the statics.
Okay.
So it depends on the region and it depends on what you're actually doing and what you're actually using it for and what kind of roof you're implementing it on, so what kind of region you're in. So we kind of take all these factors into consideration and we tell you exactly where and how many of these pieces you need to place.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, but in theory, you could go on ad infinitum.
Absolutely. This, we don't mind. If you don't want to put weights on your roof, let's say your roof is kind of structurally unstable or old, you have a choice to use this anchoring system we call the eye catcher system. Basically, what it is we have these bars that run from rail to rail, which I can attach like this.
Okay.
And we pin them down.
Locks in place.
It locks into the rails and we pin them down using these circular anchors. And basically they replace the ballast tray.
But would you still, you'd still leave the ballast tray
we
in
do not,
for any support?
No, it's replaced
not necessarily.
Yeah. So if you don't want to put stones or weight concentrated on one part of the roof, you can replace it easily with these anchor parts,
okay.
And then you're good to go, basically.
And these anchor parts are?
Different types, of course.
I mean, adjustable in case your roof's not completely flat?
They could, depending on which type you're using, we can go from 5 degrees all the way up to 15 degrees, but we have to know exactly what kind of substructure the roof has.
Yeah.
And then we have to plan it accordingly, because we are going to tell you where to place this, how far apart we are going to place this, and which type to use depending on your roof finishes.
Okay.
So we have the completely adhesive using one,
yeah.
Of course. This we call the non-fixed. And then we have the fixed versions where we use a little bit of screw system.
So many tiny screws.
And if you have like a concrete roof, we can use one big, basically
raw bolt,
yeah,
into
robust the screw into the concrete finish, and it doubles as the entire.
So how does the middle one work then?
This one is the adhesive one, so what we have is like a molten adhesive material,
like a bitumen sort of.
Exactly, like a bitumen, so you have to heat it, kind of melts, and then you use both surfaces to create some sort of adhesive joint.
Yeah.
Which
so
would
it
anchor
literally
it down.
Glues down.
It literally yeah. glues down. There you go.
Wow.
Yeah, so you have these options, which is quite great if you have older roofs. Nice to have that option.
Yeah.
Not everybody
As
wants
you say,
to
when you can't put a lot of weight on the roof.
Exactly, and the structural integrity of the entire roof is
okay.
question.
So what's
so
the
we're
next
ready
step?
For the PV
That's it.
Now.
Ready for the panel.
It is.
Right.
All right. So we put this ready on your end?
Yeah.
All good? After we've put the panel on, the next step would be to put on the side deflectors or the wind deflectors. These would be these articles right here. So these have like many uses. So when you have heavy wind load or an uplift force coming from the sides from different directions, this would actually reduce that load depending on where you put it on the roof. And it also protects against like birds and some small animals.
Oh, so it's like a built-in vermin guard as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, like a guard wall around the PV panel.
And you only need these at the ends of each run, or do you need one in the middle?
So depending on what array you have, you would have one on either side of the panel. So if you connect it from end to end, you would go, depending on if it's a south system or an east-west system, putting on the right type of wind sheets.
And the south system is very similar to this, but they're only half the...
Exactly, just ends on the half of...
At the halfway mark.
Yeah. So what we do is just put it on top of the rails right here. Has the grooves for it as well.
Oh, yeah.
It's pretty easy to see.
Yeah. It just locates in really nicely, actually.
Goes into the groove. And then the final step would be to hold everything together with some pins or the clips.
Just the clamps that...
Exactly. So it kind of puts everything together.
So again, so it's just a mid-end... As you'd normally go down your array and then end when you
exactly.
finish.
Exactly.
So it's nothing particularly more complicated than a normal panel
absolutely.
On the roof install.
This is actually kind of fun also to do. Fun to practice. Obviously, I'm not the best at it, as we've seen. But when you kind of look at the whole picture, and the uses and the innovation it kind of went into designing this. Each time you do this, each time you assemble this, you kind of see where they are coming from. Each and every part has its own use, its own innovation, and its own improvement from the previous generation. So I think this will continue in the improvements to come, but for now, this is actually in the market one of the easiest, if not the easiest to assemble.
I was gonna say, it does seem so straightforward.
It really is.
And the ability to assemble what was probably 60, 70% of it on the ground.
Absolutely.
You know, you're not just having to ferry up great big huge heavy anything.
Exactly.
Apart from maybe the ballast at the end of the
ballast.
When you
still gave you an option for that.
Yeah.
So
you can, as you say, you can mount it. So it's good for sort of maybe listed buildings where you couldn't go through a roof.
Yeah. So we do structural analysis for roofings, and then we have a certain per square meter load bearing ability that we have
like
to have.
Like an allowance.
Exactly.
Yeah.
To make sure that it's in the safe range. If it's not within that safe range, then we tell the customer, maybe we can provide you with another option, and we tell them about the anchors.
Right.
But usually, the roofs can sustain such loads. So
for most instances, this with the ballast is a nice normal.
Exactly. So if you just want a clean finish also without any kind of ballast on your roof, you can also go for the anchoring system. Yeah. So kind of looks fun.
Brilliant. Yeah. It's so straightforward.
Yeah.
Solomon, thank you
Pleasure.
Very much.
Of course.